Respected chief guests, eminent personalities on the stage, respected guardians, parents, and my dear brothers and sisters. Today, on the occasion of first annual function of Gurukul Takshshila, I would like to throw lights on Gurukul system of education. In today's world, man has achieved almost everything he wants. In a way, we can say that he has transformed the ancient traditional world into a mechanical and developed one. But the history is witness. Whenever there comes a lot of merits and demerits comes with it. And one of the most big demerits is the lack of moral value in future generation. It is like a curse for all of us. In such cases, introduction to Gurukul system is the best way to cope up with prevailing challenges. Man by birth doesn't possess the spiritual thinking and spiritual mental attitude. It can be only introduced by his parents or gurus. But parents can mold their child mind toward positivity only up to an extent. After that, a child will faith in his teacher and start thinking his teacher is always right. That's why a teacher play a vital role in the success of a person. Today, we have forgotten the ancient objective of education stated by great rishis and munis. Actually, the word education has been derived from the Latin word educare, which means to draw out the best in a man. Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati, who revived Gurukul system of education, believed education is a manifestation of divine perfection already exists in a man. In fact, education is an instrument which prepares people mentally as well as physically. The aims of education are character building, holistic development of personality, observing the social duty, promotion and protection of national culture. Only Gurukul system of education can fulfill these aims. Ladies and gentlemen, our forefathers believed that child can learn from the nature. Therefore, they established Gurukul Away in the order to bring the child direct contact with the nature. Children are lived together irrespective of their caste, class and reason. Children are kept separately from the society in order to make them understand of life, brotherhood and equality. The children who live here is called Brahmachari or Dhammacharini. Brahmachari are supposed to have faith in their gurus. Gurus treat them as sons. Gurus are learned and experienced and they share their learnings and experience with their pupils. Gurukul are the only center with the real knowledge and wisdom. When it comes to modernity, the children of Gurukul try to keep pace with the changing technology of the world. At present, there is a dire need of a Gurukul in our country. Therefore, I humbly request you to support the Gurukul system of education. Otherwise, a mess may destroy our national culture through their powerful satellite media of television. Once again, on the behalf of a Gurukul Takshshila management and Brahmachari, I will heartily feel your applying for your kind cooperation and contribution in keeping alive most valuable Gurukul system of education.